Hello, I'm fikishac, and this is the CACE International Show. We have the drums of fire, Mr. Mor Thiam from Senegal, to play for us. Mr. Mor Thiam. International Show, and I'm fikishac. Our guest is Ambassador to Senegal, Mr. Mor Thiam.
Thank you.
I'm so glad that you're here.
Thank you.
Oh yes, this was a wonderful, wonderful exhibition we just did there. We're going to go to our CACE gallery now. We have Cablevision, who does functional sculpture. He works in wood and glass and steel. And he learned his craft in his native home, St. Vincent, in New York, in Mexico, and in France. He takes man, inanimate objects, and nature, and builds his creative art. And when I listen to the music of Mr. Mor Thiam, on a tune called Change. And we'll be back and talk with him all about his art. Enjoy.
I live in Senegal, but I'm an African.
in Africa before the sophistication, even now, tradition still remain the same and still respected. And Guillot, which the French people call Guillot, which is given the historians, my ancestors, I am an historian. My first name is Mor, which is religion Islamic. The last name is my speciality. The middle name is my heritage and my ancestors, which is Dogo, the king of drum. I mean Dogo.
So all your family were drummers and your family was...
Exactly.
Yeah?
My third to fourth generations, all of them Dogo drummers.
So now, does it... I'm trying to understand how is the historian thing come out through the drums. I mean, is it... You tell a story on the drums?
Exactly. Drum is like... It's a universal communications. Before the sophistication, we use drum to communicate up to this minute. And the drum can tell when you walk in this room, the wigwam playing, tell the people what noble, which area of the noble you came from. And the rhythm was telling you exactly who you are, where's your character, where's your biography, where's your background, your ancestors. The rhythm go to your blood, all the way to your brain. That why in Africa, when you see a griot, don't have to necessarily work. He's always king until he die. People give him money, give him gold, give him silver, give him everything. Because he keep the secret, this confidence of humanity himself.
That's interesting because, you know, when they brought us here from Africa, they took away our drums.
Exactly.
But because that was our communication.
Well, in fact, I have an interview today from Philadelphia on the major paper because I'm doing a concert on the 12th. That's a question they ask me. And I tell them, the people, the white people who took the drum from African Americans, they really not thinking. Because on the other hand, drums still remain. The drums speaking through the mountain of the hill, which is the Indians.
But they were thinking, because that's why they didn't want us to keep
it. No, because don't forget, when they took the drum out, they think they're safe. What about Cape Walk? There's a rhythm, they're using their hands and they clap. The same rhythm I'm playing, the same thing they was using. They communicate through among them.
So we just changed form of
things. Exactly.
That's a
rhythmically changed.
Where have you taught drumming?
I came in the United States in 1968 and working with Miss Catherine Dunham at Southern Illinois University. For 17 years, I am the head of percussion departments. Teach almost every drum you can name, my students all over the United States, including Europe, all over North America, everywhere.
You were at Boston University?
No, Southern Illinois University in East St. Louis, Illinois.
Okay, but I thought that I had read somewhere where you had also done some work.
Those is a residency. I do a lot of residency. Stanford, Malcolm X College, Boston, all the major universities throughout the United States, including North America. To that Tobago, you know, everywhere.
So when did you work with, like, Nancy Wilson and B.B. King?
That was a drought. We have a drought, you remember, many years ago. It was a drought in West Africa between Sahara and Mali. We have no water.
Still is a drought.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So then my ambassador called me and said, we have to do fundraising for drought. That way I'd be able to work with B.B. King, Nancy Wilson, and the White House. In the time of Nixon.
Oh, so it was a good one.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Where did you guys do this?
Well, we went in Washington, D.C. Uh-huh. Yeah, we did in the White House.
I was also reading where you are involved with fusing traditional African rhythms with jazz and funk.
Exactly.
Talk to me about that.
Well, you know, I'm right now, my music and drumming has begun to respond all over in the world.